So we started with an input to SAT, and that is going to be a Boolean formula with n variables, and these are going to be, as always, x1, x2, and so on until you reach xn. And we are also going to specify the number of clauses, and I'm just going to use the letter m here, so we're going to say we have m clauses. And I'm also going to give them names, so I'm going to call them c1, c2, and so on until you reach cm. And we're now going to construct a graph that represents or encodes this Boolean formula here. And we are going to do this just as we have done before. So this part here is going to represent x1. This part over here is going to represent x2, and so on. And this one here, xn. Now, the question, of course, is how long these parts for each x need to be. And that depends on the number of clauses, because we're going to attach clauses to the variables here. In order to make this safe, we should construct this part so that we have m of these edge crossings here, because then we know that for each clause we have an edge where we can attach that clause to. Now, if we have m of these crossings here, this means that we have m plus 1 of these groups of 3 vertices here. So we have 3 times m plus 1 vertices in this part here, and then we have one more vertex here, one more vertex here, so plus 2 if we extend it like this. And this holds true for all of the other parts here as well. Now, for each clause, we're of course also going to add a vertex, like so. And again, this vertex here is going to represent clause number 1, this vertex here is going to represent clause number 2, and so on until we get to clause number m. So my first question for you is, how many vertices are we using to represent the variables? So to represent x1, x2, and so on until we get to xn. And I would like you to enter this as 4 numbers. So it's going to be some number times n plus some number times m plus some number times mn plus possibly some constant. So please give me these 4 numbers here to correctly count the number of vertices that we have here to represent variables.